They star on one of the most talked about new series of the fall. You've probably seen all the billboards around town, maybe in your town too. It's called Dads. The show premieres tomorrow night at 8 on Fox.
Fox.
I want you to check
action theta.
How could you invite him? Why would you do that?
I'll tell you why. Because 2 years ago, you blew an Indian food burp right in my face. And it's payback time.
30 seconds of burp smell does not equal multi-day dad visit.
Hey, you send one of mine to the hospital, I send one of yours to the morgue. Dance to Chicago away. Besides, a couple days with your dad is not going to be the end of the world.
Are you kidding me? It's the worst. Please welcome Seth Green and Giovanni. Ribisi. Arsenio for a second. Amazon Women on the Moon, which is a sketch comedy movie.
Yes.
It's one of the funniest movies ever, and it was one of the things that was instrumental in being inspirational for Robot Chicken.
Oh,
that kind of like free-form crazy sketch comedy, yeah.
And
if you've never seen Arsenio like plugs in a TV, his hair's all crazy. He's like the most unfortunate man in this movie.
Yes,
it's
yes.
Awesome.
A lot of bad luck in that scene.
Yes.
So you are aware of a lot of films I didn't know you were aware of.
Oh, really? Yeah.
You're a big buff, huh?
Yeah. I watch a lot of TV movies. Yeah. Isn't that what we do? We're Americans.
Are you a film buff also?
I try to be a film buff. I try to watch movies, but I don't know. I mean, yeah. Yeah, I could say that. I don't know. That's a half.
You can tell you gotta watch the show. He's funny already, right? You know what? I'm looking at the clip. You and I have incredible chemistry. Have you ever worked together before? And how long have you known
each other? A really long time. Giovanni was one of the first people I met when I moved to California.
Yeah.
And plus, just as kids in the business, you wind up meeting all the same people. And if you have any kind of longevity, you wind up seeing the same people over and over again.
Right, from like early teens, we're talking. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
And you all did something like a commercial together?
We did a Fruit Loops commercial together.
But I
was on the set of My Two Dads, all that kind of thing. Like, we've actually been peripheral in each other's lives in a big
way. About the hair.
That's the unfortunate thing. You can probably relate to this. Like, all the most embarrassing things that I've ever done are cataloged on the internet for everyone to look at. All of the unfortunate hairstyles, clothing choices that I made.
I don't know if yours
was as unfortunate as mine was, but I mean, I guess.
I had a kitten play high top fade that kind of folded to the sides.
Sort of like curly hair manes that I'm still trying to get over, obviously, with the stuff.
Kid play might win that contest.
Yeah.
Kid play, I guess. Yes. You are actually a dad, and you are not.
Not a dad, no.
Right. What's your daughter thinking about billboards all over the town? And
I know, it's a trip. It's a trip, I think, for everybody in my family. You know, I don't know. It's you know, I've definitely been an actor for all my life, and you know, sometimes it happens, but on that level, it's definitely, you know, they're really putting a lot of juice behind the show, I guess.
Yeah, they really want you to watch the show.
Yeah. And it's worth it. I mean, I think the show is really funny. I think I'm proud of it.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I still suspect it's really, really funny. And you've got Martin Mull in the mix, who's a legendary comedy actor.
Yeah, really funny guy. Just a privilege to work with him. And one of the big draws, I think, for both of us.
And Peter Rieger plays my dad, and then we got Brenda Song, who a lot of people know from Disney TV, and Vanessa Lachey, a lot of people know from MTV, and Tanita Castro brings an entirely, she is a superstar in Mexico.
Yeah,
it's been awesome.
How much does being a dad help you in this?
I don't know. I mean, you know, a lot of people have been asking about, you know, if there are similarities with my father and Martin Mull and the relationships that we have there. And I would say that I'm probably a lot more like Martin Mull to my own daughter than my dad is to me. I mean, I don't know. Like my daughter is 16 years old. I have a teenager. Yeah, she just got her driver's license now. And it's true.
My kid is 13.
Getting perfect. The writers are like all of what's going on with that, you know, dealing with that, the teenage daughter.
Hey, by the way, are the critics helping? What are they thinking about this?
Oh, the critics seem to hate the show.
They're very critical. Yeah.
You know, but that's a critic's job, is to be really critical. And I tend to find that any controversy, any negative press just makes people more curious. And I think audiences are discerning. I think people can know what they like. If you watch it and you think it's funny, then it's a show for you. We're really happy with it. The writers are awesome. The same, the creators are the people that wrote the movie Ted. Anybody see that movie Ted?
Yes.
Everyone's working really hard. We're happy about it. It's weird because we're so deep into just making it, we haven't even thought about the fact that it's on the air tomorrow.
Yeah,
and even though there's advertisements all over town, we haven't really thought about the fact that this is actually happening, and if people like it, it could be a job. Like, we're just not even thinking about it. We're just focused on making it really good.
I'm surprised you've been focused, because you guys are involved in so much. You have separate companies that you need from this project that
such a long time that you sort of recognize the need to create your own opportunity, or at least manage your own destiny as much as you can. You know, you're an innovator, you're your creator, so
right.
It's the same kind of thing. You get to a point where you say, all right, well, if this is going to last, if I'm ever going to do this for the rest of my life, then I've got to take certain steps to make that possible.
Yeah, and if you can make your own decisions and be your own boss, I think that's really important and healthy as well, you know.
You consistently make choices that you wholeheartedly support because you've assembled the team that gets the job done.
Yeah, what else does your company do?
Yeah, I have a visual effects background, and I started this company called Stereo D, and it was a 3D conversion company / visual effects company.
Yeah, no big deal. All the big movies that came out that you saw in 3D, his company did the 3D. No big deal, guys.
Very modest.
Yeah.
When I was sitting at home, just watching Leno and Letterman, and I was seeing you on things. This is a weird thing. I always had a question for you,
and I
didn't have a show, and now I have a show. There is something about the way you work that always made me wonder if you ever did stand-up.
I did, yeah. Well, I grew up loving stand-up at a really young age. I was super familiar with all the stand-ups, and when I was 14 years old, I came out to L.A. to work on The Facts of Life, of all things, and is directly across Sunset from the Comedy Store, and I knew that was the world famous Comedy Store, and so I tried to go over there, and I finally convinced Missy Shore to let me go on open mic night. The only caveat was I couldn't go inside. I had to wait outside and then go directly on stage and then get directly out of there, because I was underage. I was a child. And so I did maybe five open mic nights, and then I really just gave it up.
Why? Well, it's very difficult. There's something about you that reminds you. You are a stand-up waiting to happen.
No. No. No.
I appreciate your enthusiasm, Andy.
No, it's such a... The comedians that are really brilliant, that really... I just saw Seinfeld in Vegas, and he was incredible. He's a skilled and dedicated comic. I've never really been that disciplined. I don't think I'm that kind of comic. But I did enjoy just his experience.
Yes. No one's funnier than Jerry. I want to thank both of you. Dad's premieres tomorrow night on Fox. Coming up, Oscar winning actress Melissa Leo. Who won an Academy Award for her incredible performance in The Fighter. In addition to her latest film, Prisoners, she's added an Emmy to her trophy case last night. Thanks to her much talked about role opposite Louis C.K. Y'all love Louis? I love Louis C.K. Obviously, on his show called Louis, let's take a look at some FX stuff.
Yeah, that was very good.
Nice.
Well, I don't really want to do that.
Why?
I don't want to do it. Yes.
And then when I say, well, what's this? And they say, well, it's an Emmy. Well, I know it's an Emmy Award, but what's her name?
Yeah, and I would like to have a specific name for this one. Yes, this one. Congratulations, young lady.
Thank you.
That's right. You know what? You and Louie.
Oh, dear.
First of all, you won't make it very hard on our host to pick a clip. That was a hard clip to find.
Well, you seem to have found one.
And you know what's cool is you've only done one Louis, right?
Just the one Louis.
Yeah, and your son helped make it happen?
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Well, I was nominated for an Emmy for Mildred Pierce, and we were leaving on the carpet there, and my boy who's met his death an actor too. We've seen a lot of people.
Shut the hell up, Jeff, please.
Show. I watched a bunch of episodes. I think what he's doing is absolute genius, and was thrilled to go and join them, and then I saw the script. But okay, well, I'm committed. How the heck am I going to do this? And I did a verbatim what Louis had written there on the page. Louis directing it as well, and we got to run the words a bunch. Was the thing that actors do. It's not really rehearsing. We kind of like nobody to be around because they go, oh, I like it that way, and we're just trying to get the lines down. And so that because he's in charge of it all, there was all this time that you don't usually find to sort of bat the words back and forth. He was more nervous than I to play these scenes,
yes.
Especially the one that you took a clip from. And
you all know what happened, right? Okay.
Fairly obvious, isn't it? But it's not sexually explicit. It's not that they cut that out. No, it's sexually explaining.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. How old is your son?
He's 27.
And did he finally watch the episode?
You know, he's only ever seen bits and pieces of it online. His friends have all laughed and laughed, and I think maybe it's a little hard for him to watch.
Yes. Look what he got you into.
Oh, yeah. It's his own fault. You're quite right about that.
What does he want to do with parents who are thespians?
Well, he definitely does not want to be a thespian.
Really?
And he studied at CalArts, and he is indeed a practicing artist here in Los Angeles. He has a show down in Tijuana, New Mexico right now. His very first solo show. He has a piece hanging in Scotland, so he's not only good. Jackherd.net.
Jackherd.net.
If you want to see what he's up to.
Mommy's hair looks very pretty today.
Thank you. Had a lot of help.
Now, would that be considered red? What color would that be considered?
Well, I've always thought of myself as a redhead, and then as soon as you say that, people say, well, you're not really a redhead. You're sort of more a strawberry blonde. So then I say, I'm a strawberry blonde. I say, hey, you're a redhead. So, you know, whatever you would like to call it, it's not brown,
mm-hmm.
And it's not blonde.
Strawberry blondes and brown-headed people have an easier life than redheads, because redheads have a lot of stereotypes attached.
Yes, I don't know how you'd be able to relate to that, but somehow I think perhaps you could. He writes great things about redheads, and indeed, when I've dived around for a part, and you know, it's one thing on a set, but you have your days off, and you're walking around town, and a brunette gets a good morning, and a blonde gets a good morning,
mm-hmm.
And a redhead gets a...
Because people think they're mean.
Mean, they steal your boyfriend, they got a temper, ask anyone who's around me. None of that's true.
Let's talk about Christmas.
Oh, let's switch the subject, Ben. First of all, it's a gripping edge-of-your-seat thriller. There's no question about it. That's what is being advertised, and you see that, and I see that. I was on the edge of my seat, even though I know exactly what happens. And beyond that, it is also probably one of the finest films I've ever had the pleasure to be in. And I'm talking serious filmmaking. The director took a script that had a great deal of potential, beautifully written script. He cast it impeccably. We've got Viola Davis and Terrence Howard and Paul Dano and Hugh Jackman and Jake Gyllenhaal and detectives in a film I've ever seen, and I know because I taught him everything he knows. When I was on Homicide many years ago, when we were both younger, and Jake was a 7-year-old boy, and his dad directed the episode. His first acting job was as the son of a murder victim in Baltimore, and I was the detective on the case.
He's a wonderful actor.
Yeah, so in Prisoners, he is the detective, and by my viewing, the hero of the film. Everyone will have their own opinion about that, and that's one of the really exciting things about the film, is sort of to talk about it afterwards, and what would you do, and what'd you think when they did that, and boy, would you do what Terrence does or what Viola does, and it's interesting.
Now, you brought a clip.
I did indeed.
Yeah, you should set this up.
Okay, I'll set it up. Holly Jones, the woman that I play, is a very lonely woman living in this small town that we all live in, a town in which two children have been abducted. You're meeting Holly, and Detective Loki is getting his first meeting with this lonely woman who lives in the town that he's protecting.
Okay, y'all watch your monitors. Okay, kick it.
That's my husband.
We had a fight. She's 5 years ago.
Walked out, didn't come back. Alex left him like a father.
Where are Alex's real parents?
My husband's brother and his girlfriend. They died in a car accident when Alex was about 6.
Toyota Music Performance with the band Perry. Toyota, let's